All right, so today we're going to just take a look at Tesla again. If you remember in the bigger picture, and I posted this on Twitter way back when it tested this key support here, we had symmetry with a prior major decline of 145.60. This decline ended up being 145.02. It also overlapped a 618 retracement, another symmetry projection, and the timing was similar. So for example, you know, this decline at that point was 28 weeks down, and then that was similar to this swing down of 29 and this swing down of 29, okay? So that's one of the reasons why I had looked at Tesla way back then and also put out a potential upside target. And again, it's potential. It's obviously not guaranteed, and I don't know if we're gonna get there for sure, but we sure have seen a nice rally since this time and price low was made, right? But this is where, you know, the typical target comes from, and that's just from running the extension of this high to this low and then extend it upwards, which also, strange little fact, is the base to the height of pyramid of Giza is also 1.272. Anyway, beyond that, if you take it down to the daily chart, you know, I'm certainly not going to tell you that you should buy it anywhere and assume it's going to go there. That's crazy. But if you can find a relatively low-risk entry with defined risk, it's worth looking at. And I found this pullback was pretty well defined. This was an area to look at for possible support, this 345.70. And as we pulled back into it, we pulled back into timing cycles. So we've got a cycle here, 13th, 14th, 13th, 14th. Well, there's a couple on the 16th too. But bottom line, since we were pulling back into that zone, we were going to look for a possible resumption to back up. And if we do continue to hold above this 345 area, my initial upside target's going to be here. But guess what? I'm going to be wrong if it takes out this last low. Okay? You have to define your risk. Some of my traders might, you know, use the lower support as an area to define risk. It really depends on what kind of strategies. Most of my guys are and gals are trading options, so it really depends on what kind of strategy you're using as far as how much, you know, you might risk, okay? Anyway, but that's what I'm looking at. Support here, if we continue to hold, I'm going to look for higher prices, and I'm going to consider myself wrong if it takes out the low.